Retraction settings could be one of the most important factors in getting the best prints possible off your 3D printer, but it's also one of the more mysterious settings within your 3D printing slicer. So in this 3D Printing 101, we're going to talk all about retraction. Hi, welcome back to 3D Printing 101 here on Makers Muse. So what is retraction anyway? Well, first, let's look at a 3D print with retraction completely disabled and see what results we get. I put this simple design together which requires the print head to travel between two columns during the print. This will help demonstrate our issue. So this is called stringing, and it's a very undesirable effect of the extruder oozing plastic out as it moves between points of the print. You see, as the extruder pushes filament into the hot end, this creates pressure, and this pressure wants to equalize, so simply stopping the extruder won't actually stop plastic oozing out of the nozzle. So this can make a print look terrible, and while tweaking temperatures can help to some degrees, printing with no retraction will always leave a subpar result when printing complicated models. Okay, great Angus, but how do we stop stringing? Well, this is called retraction. Retraction actually pulls filament back up from the hot end a short amount after each print move. There's actually a bit of a myth around retraction that somehow creates a suction and sucks molten plastic back into the hot end, but that's not actually the case. All retraction is doing is relieving that pressure, so when you do a travel move, the plastic's not gonna so easily ooze out. So let's turn on basic retraction settings within Simplify 3D and see what our results are. Here I'm telling the printer to move the filament back 10 millimeters into the hot end at a speed of around 80 millimeters per second after each print move. Let's see how this turns out. Clearly, there's a huge improvement straight away in this print over the original. The stringing is almost completely gone, but it's not perfect. There's still a few tiny wisps on the model. So even with retraction, it can take a short amount of time for the filament to stop oozing out of a nozzle. That's why we have more advanced retraction settings you can activate. For example, we can coast the extruder, which will turn extrusion off a fraction before the print move is completed. This helps to relieve the pressure even more when it does a travel move and helps to eliminate that little bit of stringing that we had left behind. We can also wipe the extruder, which moves it back into the print a short amount to help wipe off any additional oozing. And this is the final result after all of our tweaks using retraction. It's pretty much perfect. I could spend a little bit more time tweaking my retraction settings further to get even better results, but at the stage it is now, I'm confident to move on to more complicated prints, knowing that I'm not going to get any stringing issues. It's actually pretty amazing how much of a difference these settings make versus our original print with no retraction settings at all. You can have too much of a good thing, however, and it is possible to have too much retraction. Too much retraction in your print becomes evident with little pockmarks of under extrusion at certain areas of a print when it moves between a travel to a print move. Retraction also puts a lot of force on your filament as it sucks it back up and down quickly into the extruder head, and this can sometimes lead to the extruder gear chewing filament and leading to jams. So if you're having this issue, maybe slow down your retraction speeds and minimize the amount of movement it's doing, which will help minimize this filament grinding and chewing problem. It's also possible you may need to prime your nozzle when it moves between areas if you're trying to stop stringing, but also start a print without any under extrusion issues. If you are getting under extrusion at the start of each print move, this is the setting you want to try tweaking. You're also spending a lot of time doing these retractions, so obviously print time will increase if you're using retraction settings, but is it really a big deal if you're getting a better quality print? And as a final pro tip, if you're trying to 3D print with flexible materials like Ninja Flex, then you'd probably want to turn retraction completely off. This is because as you're trying to 3D print the flexible materials, retraction will tend to stretch and compress those flexible filaments and will probably most likely lead to a jam in your extruder head. So if you are 3D printing with flexible materials and you do want to manage stringing issues, there's actually a setting within Simplify 3D you can turn on to try to help this without using retraction. It's called avoid crossing outlines for travel movements and means that the stringing will be mostly internalized into the print. So if you're printing with flexible materials like a TPU, and for example with my Flexion extruder, I tend to turn this on because it avoids the stringing being on the outside of the print. It's obviously not perfect for all prints, but it can certainly save your bacon if you're trying to 3D print flexible materials without too much stringing. So thanks for watching. Next time you're having stringing issues, I hope this video helps you nail down your retract settings, which will help you turn a good print into a really great one, lets you move to printing very complicated shapes like this without any stringing issues at all. If you enjoy this 3D Printing 101 on Makers Muse, guys, don't forget to subscribe. It helps me out a huge amount. I love bringing these 3D printing tips, tricks, and reviews to you. Also, if you want to get a cool t-shirt like this one, you can find the link to it in the video description. I look forward to seeing you again very shortly here on Makers Muse. Catch you later. Bye.